ArtSpark Texas and Pen to Paper Creative Writing Contest present The Lion and Pirate, an inclusive virtual open mic for writers, performers, and musicians.
We wanted to mention today is that I think probably most of y'all have seen on Facebook or through the grapevine or email is that we kind of lost a giant in the Lion and Pirate community. Susie Angel passed away last month after just a big, complicated battle with a lot of things. And, you know, she was one of the folks who got this event off the ground with me and April from ArtSpark Texas, back when it was VSA, and Becky from Malvern Books. All of us, you know, kind of got this going back in, I don't even know how long, 2016, 15, 14, I don't know. Time is, you know how it is. So yeah, and you know, it wasn't just the Lion and Pirate that she was a huge part of. Everything that the Coalition of Texans with Disabilities did, she, you know, a lot of our stuff she had a hand in. We did the Pen to Paper Creative Writing Contest together for 11 years. She did a ton of advocacy work and communications work with us, and her decline and absence, we're still getting our heads around it and navigating it. So if you go to Malvern's Facebook page, and just search, or if you go to their YouTube page and search Susie's name, all of the, they did a great job with labeling everything. So all of the Lion and Pirate videos that she has done will pop up, and you can watch her stories and poems and multiple dance pieces.
May I say something?
Of course, my darling.
I ever say, I'm sorry, from the bottom of my heart. I want to thank everybody that performed me to the honor it being. I wish I could go back and listen to it again, but, thank you from the bottom of my heart. Really, that's to me. If you didn't understand, Lord, could you repeat me?
Sure. Juan said, thank you from the bottom of his heart. To everybody who performed a piece in Susie's honor, means the world to him. And he's sorry he wasn't here.
Perfect for. So what I think about of Susie, just swirling and whirling and laughing. But Susie made me laugh a lot. She was funny. And yeah.
She loved to laugh too.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Funny, 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 smart, funny.
Yeah,
I think she may have a hand in all of our technical issues today, just to prank us.
Yes, absolutely.
Messing yeah. with us.
Mm-hmm.
Next on the lineup is Joanne, and I'm really excited because she's busting out a new instrument today. Joanne.
All right, now this is kind of an experiment because I don't know how the sound. Hey, good enough. All right, this is a song called Whales. It's one of my old songs, but I don't usually play it on the accordion. But as I was practicing it, I realized it's kind of appropriate to send this out to Susie. So here we go.
So this is my tribute to Susie. Before I start, I had a brief thing to talk about. Let me turn on my mic. Okay, so one of my last conversations that I had with Susie before she parted ways to the creator was about my art journey. I told her for a little while I would not be continuing my art journey, wanting to focus more on theater and on tilt, which meant I would no longer be an artist for a little while at Arts Park, Texas, because I would be putting my main focus in theater. And she said, "Will you still be a part of Modern Books?" even though you're busy with Tilt? Like, she was just so like, ugh. And I said, yes, Susie, I promise I will keep coming back to Marvin Books. And with that being said, I made a promise, so I'll keep coming back and singing songs for her. But anywho, I would like to perform this song for Susie. This is No One Is Alone from Into the Woods. No one here to guide you. Now you're on your own. Only me beside you. Still you're your own. No one is alone. Truly, no one is alone. Sometimes people leave you halfway to the point. Others may deceive you. You decide what's good. You decide alone. No one is alone. People make mistakes. Mothers, mothers, people make mistakes. Holding to their own. Thinking they're alone.
This poem is also going out to Susie. I think one of the last times I interacted with Susie was in the open mic after I read a poem, and she left me a really nice encouraging comment in the chat. And it's really just something I've never forgotten. And whenever I'm writing poetry, I think about that. So, you know, my love goes out to Susie and also to Juan. I've since changed the title of this one, but The Bird and Harvey Parties is this is from a poetry project I've got with it's all the poem is right otherwise, but the reference of Bird and Harvey is it's one of the many Siri mistakes I've encountered. So Bird and Harvey is a birding hobby. That's what came out, Bird and Harvey. Anyway, so you don't have to write it. It's all good. Anyway, a heart becomes a bird. That's how it starts. A swallow flits impossible feats over fields of dead corn, or maybe a fly catcher hunts from the rib cage, rust wings and a lemon belly in pursuit of a beetle. Watch it weave through the aortic canopy, alight atop its sternal lookout, eyeing some cellular prey. I used to believe we were all a kind of bird, rising restlessly on the wind. Poor feathered thing, flying home to home like a child of divorce. But now I see us pecking, cracks in a calcified egg, then dropping with a thud to a flightless world, and, if we're lucky, fluttering back up. Crusty yellowed leaves reunited with the branch, and in their green reverie, forgetting they were ever earth laden. And though I sense a certain clutter, shifting principles like piles of debris, I still cling to that promise. What I mean to say is, the heart was always a bird, and deep within its cavity, life begins again.
All right, Michael.
I had a poem prepared, but me and Amy talked last night, and I would just like to say a few words, especially after all I heard today and all I've been watching and looking at. Lion the Pirate is a truly special place because it is a place where we all can come, be ourselves, disability or not. And that is what Susie stood for. And to me, that's what her legacy is. So I would ask everyone to just embrace who you are, no matter what background you come from or what sexual orientation or ethnicity you are. Because at the end of the day, we're all family, and everybody matters in this group, because that is what she would want. That's who she was. Thank you.
I think I've done a version of this song before, and I probably should not have both the earphones on. There we go. And I wrote this. It was originally written for a little girl who died, who was a dancer. And there were two reasons why I wanted to do this song. One, the little girl was a dancer, like Susie, and the other, was because it's called Dancing with Angels, and that's Susie. So let's see if I can get through it. Okay, breathe. Don't worry. Sorry, I got a hairball. Don't worry, family, I'm dancing with angels. Don't worry, family, I'm dancing with God. Don't you be oh God. It's a day for it. I need to breathe. Don't worry, family, I'm dancing with angels. Don't worry, family, I'm dancing with God. Don't you be crying, I'm dancing with angels. Whirling and twirling and laughing with God. 'Cause where we all are is at the beginning. Where we are now is where it all starts. What we will be is lost in the living. Who we will be is found in our hearts. So don't worry, family, I'm dancing with angels. Don't worry, family, I'm dancing with God. Don't you be crying, I'm dancing with angels, whirling and twirling and laughing with God. Then also we had a tribute that we did to Susie, of course, who was part of Lion and Pirate for a long time, who died this year.
Yeah.
Obviously, you know, one of your closest friends. And so it was beautiful to see how she impacted everybody who comes to the Lion and Pirate. Susie was involved when it was live and was a coordinator for Pen to Paper, mm-hmm. the writing competition for people with disabilities. And her work is incredible. Her writing is incredible. And it's more incredible because it takes her so long to write it, because the way she has to write on how does she do it on? She sits on the floor and types letter by letter.
Yeah.
And yeah. So it was, as somebody with ADHD, I find that I'm just in awe of that. I'm like, I got to get done quick. And I don't have that kind of perseverance.
Right.
So,
yeah.
And her sense of humor.
Yeah, always.
Sponsored by ArtSpark Texas and the Coalition of Texans with Disabilities. For more content, feel free to look at one of our suggested videos below. Or if you really love us, listen to our podcast, True Tales by Disability Advocates, which will be linked in the description. For more information, contact Boy at artsparktexas.org, artsparktex.org.